the course of last few months, we have to know that Honor has come a long way from a Huawei sub-brand to a standalone company that launches extremely popular models on the market and no longer clones its older brother's models. If you're wondering why we're talking about Honor in a Huawei phone review, it's because it will seem that the two companies have now swapped their positions. What is this really about? Why would the same phone appear first in Honor and then in Huawei's lineup? The answer is a well-known sanction imposed on the Chinese manufacturer by the US government, which caused some models to shift their previous intended markets. So now, Huawei and Honor are trying to market phones that support Google services to the European market, even though they may not have been originally intended for it. The latest Huawei and Honor phones to be certified are Huawei Nova 5T, the phone we're reviewing today, and Honor 9X, which is due for release in early November. These phones came out a few months ago when they were initially announced for the Chinese market, and since the ban didn't take place then, they received their Google certificates. What happened next? We'll see. At the moment, no one knows, and we suspect the companies themselves don't know certainly what the future brings, both for Huawei and Google. So, back to our initial claim, why did we say that Huawei and Honor have swapped positions? It is because the device is identical to Honor 20, which came out this summer. Now, whether Honor 20 is a copy of Nova 5T phone or vice versa is a little hard to argue because they actually came out around the same time period, but the Nova 5T was initially only released in Chinese market. Due to all that happening in the meantime, Nova 5T appeared in Europe a few months after Honor 20 phone. And interestingly, even some applications such as synthetic benchmarks recognize the phone as Huawei Honor 20. Does that mean you don't have to watch this if you've already seen Honor 20 review? Well, looking at the design, Nova 5T resembles Honor 20 in every way, from design to its dimension. However, Huawei Nova 5T is not as aggressive looking, at least in black color, while other color models offer a specific design that is far more attractive. Definitely, a black phone does not highlight all the advantages and qualities the design that other variants of the phone do. However, it is undeniable that this is a pretty phone with relatively thin edges and fairly small looking. Today, in an era of 19.5 to 9 displays, the 6.26 inch phone looks very compact. However, we will not claim that it's a small phone. Simply think of it as a medium-sized phone that fits perfectly in hand. Now, the bad thing is that Nova 5T does not have any protection, or rather, no safety glass on it. Glass is, of course, also on the back of the device, but no information was provided on what type of glass it was used. And it has also no 3.5mm connector or microSD slot. It also has no support for wireless charging or an OLED screen, but these are missing features that may or may not have been treated as a flaw, since the phone, at least on paper, is a mid-range device. When it comes to the screen, Nova 5T comes with an identical IPS screen as an aforementioned Honor 20. The screen size is 6.26 inches and the resolution is 2340x1080 pixels. This means that, in practice, it will have a display density of 412 ppi and that the aspect ratio is 19.5 to 9, so the phone lies perfectly in the hand. By default, the screen color display is more cool than neutral, although very good software allows for kind of fine adjustments. It's a very nice and bright lit screen with a punch hole camera in the top corner. Its diameter is only 4.5 millimeters, and unlike various competitors who have implemented such cameras with a far larger diameter, which is much more noticeable. Not far from the cameras, at the very end of the earpiece speaker, there's also a notification light. The Huawei Nova 5T comes with Android 9 Pie operating system, as well as the company's EMUI 9.1 interface, which is very polished and offers a flawless user experience. Unlocking via face recognition is also supported. However, honestly, we recommend using an excellent fingerprint scanner. It is just like on Honor 20, it's not placed below the screen, but exactly where it's most logical for it to be, inside the phone's power button. So it's enough to put your finger on the button and the phone unlocks immediately. The whole operation takes a very short time and extremely comfortable in every sense. The Huawei Nova 5T comes with only one speaker, which is rather decent but nothing special in terms of quality. As we already mentioned, the phone does not come with a 3.5mm jack, which is a way bigger disadvantage in this price range than in higher categories. The only consolation for all the music enthusiasts is that the phone comes with the support for Huawei Hisense sound effects. The phone also comes with a USB-C to 3.5mm adapter. Nova 5T uses very well-known hardware, the high-silicon Kirin 980, which already debuted on several other Honor and Huawei phones. The phone also has 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage space. Unfortunately, although it supports dual SIM, there is no room for a memory card slot, not even in the form of a hybrid SIM slot, so you should consider in advance that expanding the memory of this phone is impossible. The battery is 3750mAh, just like on the Honor 20 phone. The phone comes with a 22.5W turbocharger, which should charge the phone up to 50% via USB-C in only 24 minutes. The camera system is also the same as in the Honor Doppelganger, so the Huawei Nova 5T comes with 4 sensors on the back. Most of the work is done by the 48MP and 16MP sensors. This is a combination of 16MP ultra-wide sensor and a standard 48MP quad bias sensor that we've came across so many times this year in other phones, which is not a bad thing since it's a IMX586 sensor that delivers great results in actual use. A 16MP ultra-wide sensor will deliver wide-angle photo capabilities that look very beautiful and bring new perspective to the frame. The main sensor has an aperture of f1.8 and supports phase detection autofocus. As you know, this sensor, which is made by Sony, has a pixel size of 0.8 micrometers that can combine in groups of 4 to effectively deliver the equivalent of 12MP with a pixel size of 1.6 micrometers, which is currently the best resolution in the mobile industry. The ultra-wide sensor has an aperture of f2.2 and, like all related solutions, does not have an advanced autofocus or assistance systems, unlike the main sensor. However, its role is such that focus is not a problem due to the sheer width of the captured scene. Also, the phone has 2 2-megapixel sensors. One is the standard depth sensor we've seen so many times before, and the other is a specific macro sensor, which captures objects from extreme proximity for some close-up shots. The manufacturer recommends a distance of about 4cm for the best experience. Also, this device doesn't come with a telephoto sensor. AI photography is supported and its quality is quite standard for Huawei phones. Nighttime shooting is very good, with overexposed photos that capture a high level of detail from every shot, even when taken in low light conditions. Also, we already got to know the 32MP selfie camera on several phones this year, and it did a great job this time again. Nova 5T is also showing a significant improvement in the video recording domain, so we've got a pretty usable and high quality 4K recordings. This is an indication that recent big advances in video quality are not only due to hardware or sensors, like for instance with Mate 30 Pro, but also due to improvement in camera software, because now, with the same sensors as the one used on beginning of this year, Huawei and Honor phones make way better videos. However, we'll also notice one big problem during our testing. The phone very often tries to refocus during the video, but if other users experience the same thing, it will easily be resolved in future software update. Weighing all the pros and cons, we have to say that this is a very good device. At 430 euros, which is roughly $475, Huawei now has a phone that is very close to what the company offers in the high class. In comparison, P30 costs quite a bit much, but Nova 5T is not less of a phone. Sure, it has an IPS instead of an OLED, lack Leica camera, but still. Again, the competition is really ruthless, and the list of what Huawei Nova 5T lacks is such that many users would probably look for alternatives. Now, Nova 5T requires users to accept certain compromises, and somewhat paradoxical, some details which are not so much of a disadvantage with the higher-end phones are harder to accept in such price range, such as the absence of a 3.5mm port or a microSD slot. There is no denying it that, generally speaking, the experience of using this phone was a pleasure, but the competition offers so much in this price range, and perhaps more important, a more up-to-date hardware. Still, Huawei has been able to take their place in the hearts of customers to whom the brand reputation is sometimes even more important than the hardware specs. And those who choose Huawei Nova 5T will certainly not make a wrong choice. Thank you once again for watching our review of Huawei Nova 5T. Don't forget to leave a like and comment below, and also subscribe to our channel for more reviews. My name is Marco, and you've been watching Bench House.